This was a disgrace. This was a rigged trial by a conflicted judge who was corrupt. It's a rigged trial, a disgrace. They wouldn't give us a venue change. We were at 5% or 6% in this district, in this area. This was a rigged, disgraceful trial. The real verdict is going to be November 5th by the people. And they know what happened here, and everybody knows what happened here.
This is not just a company. These are companies that work with companies that work with companies. And this is, of course, why we are here in the Etna Valley on the Silicon Island. And I'm happy that the Commission has also been able to do its part of this amazing project.
Ukraine is defending itself from appalling Russian brutality. So let me be clear. Self-defense is not escalation. Self-defense is a fundamental right. It is enshrined in the UN Charter. Ukraine has the right and the responsibility to protect its people. And we have the right to help Ukraine uphold its right of self-defense.
L'Italia aiuta, ha aiutato e aiuterà l'Ucraina a difendere la propria indipendenza. Quindi continueremo ad aiutarla da un punto di vista finanziario, ma anche da un punto di vista di strumenti militari. È chiaro che noi non invieremo alcun soldato italiano a combattere in territorio ucraino, così come le nostre armi non potranno essere utilizzate fuori dal territorio ucraino, perché questo lo impedisce l'articolo 11 della Costituzione.
The risk of escalation, I'm sure, will be put on the table by some. But you have to balance the risk of escalation and the need for Ukrainians to defend. Because certainly you cannot go where the attacks are coming from. You are in a completely asymmetric situation. And more it becomes crucial because the attacks to Kyiv will come from the Russian territory.
El reconocimiento del Estado de Palestina no solo es una cuestión de justicia histórica con las aspiraciones legítimas del pueblo de Palestina. Es además una necesidad perentoria si queremos entre todos lograr la paz. Es la única manera de avanzar hacia la solución que todos reconocemos como la única posible para lograr un futuro de paz.
הכוונה של מספר מדינות באירופה להכיר במדינה פלסטינית היא פרס לטרור. 80% מהפלסטינים ביהודה ושומרון תומכים בטבח הנורא של השבעה באוקטובר. לרוע הזה אסור לתת מדינה. זאת תהיה מדינת טרור.
Там, да.
Смотрите, я отключу.
Реагируй на прием.
Там я бачу, вони сіші.
Ну там є люди, да?
Багато лідерів, представників держав та міжнародних організацій, громадських діячів висловились зі співчуттям Україні та Харкову, засудили російський терор. І важливо, щоб таке засудження призвело до цілком справедливих наслідків, щоб нарешті у нас з'явилось достатньо систем ППО для захисту України, наших міст, і щоб у партнерів з'явилась достатня рішучість для превентивного захисту від російських терористів.